Jungle Deep. The podcast that explores the tropical lifestyle. Hello and welcome to the podcast Jungle Deep. This is your host, Dr. Jones. We are on safari, and I'm here with you to learn, to have fun, and to explore the jungle. Hello, this episode is part two of a two-part conversation with the founder and president of Tropical Rainforest Fund, David Seaborg. David is an evolutionary biologist and for 28 years has volunteered his time to help save the rainforest through the activities of his nonprofit organization. In this segment, we will hear about our many benefits from the rainforest, the effects of rainforest depletion on global warming, food production, biodiversity extinction, and the current mass extinction that's now going on, and how replacing biodiverse rainforests with massive monoculture crops like cacao, coffee, bananas, and oil palms does not make any sense. And now, our conversation continues.
When you have global warming, it actually causes droughts in the rainforest because the moisture goes up away from the tropical areas, and the rainforest starts to dry out. And rainforest normally has so much rain, you never get major fires in the rainforest. But now with global warming, for the first time in the last couple of decades, we've had major large fires in rainforests in Indonesia, Africa, South America, and Mexico. I should also mention that rainforests are a source of medicine. About half the world's medicines come from plants in the rainforest. Medicines come from biology. They come from animals and plants. And plants evolve chemicals to defend themselves from fungus and insect attacks. And we get these from the rainforest and then learn to synthesize them and maybe modify them. So we've got chemical medicines that help with cancer, heart disease, fungal infections. Many of them we learned from the shaman of the various shaman in the rainforest of the indigenous people who know about as much as a PhD in the United States in botany about the rainforest, except their knowledge is the uses of these plants. I should also mention, for example, the rosy periwinkle from the Madagascar rainforest has reduced the incidence of childhood leukemia from a 20% survival rate to an 80% survival rate from two alkaloids from the rosy periwinkle that are anti-cancer drugs. Furthermore, a lot of the chemicals from the rainforest are used in our day-to-day living. You can't get through a day without using rainforest products. They're used in toothpaste and shampoos and just you name it. Chemicals from the rainforest run our society. So the loss of rainforest is a very serious issue for medicine and just day-to-day living. Also, just the fact that there are half of the world's species there. This is a major cause through habitat destruction, destroying the habitats of these animals and destroying the trees directly of the extinction crisis. And we have a major mass extinction caused by people that has started right now We've had five major mass extinctions in the history of the Earth, the last one being the one that killed the dinosaurs. Now we are starting the sixth one, which is going at an ever-increasing rate. And if we continue this, it will be the sixth major mass extinction. It is very, very serious. We are sending species extinct at a rate between 1,000 and 10,000 times the normal background extinction rate.
Wow.
Yeah, animals and plants do go extinct normally.
Mm-hmm.
People ask me, isn't extinction a normal process? They ask me that as an evolutionary biologist that I am. But I say, yes, they do. But evolution evolves new species faster than the replacement rate for the normal background extinction rate, the natural background extinction rate. However, human effects have gotten that up to 1,000 to 10,000 times normal background extinction rate. And the major cause, not the only cause of this, is habitat destruction. And of the causes of habitat destruction destroying species, it's mainly, although not exclusively, the rainforest. Of course, we're killing off coral reef and temperate forest and mangrove and wetland ecosystems and others as well. But the one that's losing us the most species is the tropical rainforest. Now, this has implications not only for medicine, but for food production, because you destroy the rainforest, then the Amazon River and the other rivers of the rainforest are not protected by the trees, and they become overheated, and the trees' roots hold in the soil, and the soil goes into the rivers, and you get siltation. You get fish die-offs. Also, the fish actually eat the fruit of the rainforest trees, so they starve. Fish in the rainforest rivers are a major source of food for the third world. Also, when you destroy rainforest, you destroy the ability of local farmers to produce food. You cause drought worldwide through global warming and through the effects of the albedo and reflectivity that I mentioned earlier. We're knocking out our ability to produce food through destruction of the rainforest and also through adding greenhouse gases that cause global warming.
David, this is a complex picture, and I appreciate you going over some of the facets of this. I'm going to add to the complexity of the argument a little bit, if I may, because here on Jungle Deep, one of the things we do is to talk about the wonderful foods that we get from the tropical rainforest, and we try to shed a light on the impact of the food that's obtained and that we all enjoy. Recently, we had an episode about chocolate and the amazing tonnage of cacao beans that are farmed, in the tropical rainforest. In addition, we have a segment coming up on bananas, which is the fourth largest agricultural crop produced. Again, a tropical plant that's grown in monocultures in the tropical rainforest. Many other foods. Palm oil we talked about when we were talking about orangutans recently on an episode, talking about how they're endangered in Borneo and Sumatra, and that has a lot to do with the production, again, of another monoculture called palm oil, where these rainforests are destroyed and they're going in and growing one particular kind of plant to produce a product that the rest of the world is consuming in huge quantities. So this means huge quantities of rainforest are being destroyed in order to plant up these plantations. Can you shed a little light on the effects of plantations on tropical rainforest? Obviously, they flat out substitute the tropical rainforest with all its complexity with pretty much a single plant. What does that do?
Yeah, that's
that's got to be bad.
Well, actually, you've made two points here. You mentioned that we get a lot of crops from the rainforest. You mentioned bananas and chocolate, but we also get things like cashew nuts and a lot of different products and foods directly from the rainforest, coffee being another one, and a lot of different kinds of fruits and fish. I mentioned earlier that a lot of the temperate crops are dependent on the rainforest for climate and rain, so we're destroying the rainfall patterns through destroying rainforests, not just through destroying rainforests, but also through greenhouse gas emissions. But we're causing droughts and floods in temperate farms. So both from direct crops from the rainforest, which are manifold and many, and through indirect effects through destruction of the climate when we destroy rainforest, we are greatly decreasing our ability to grow food and increasing famine. And if we continue this trend, we will see tremendous famine in the future, and we'll see, therefore, increased conflict within and between nations. And this is very, very serious. But as far as the other point you make of palm oil, particularly in Southeast Asia, but also Brazil, they are clearing rainforest to plant palm trees and produce palm oil. Some of this for consumption at the table, some of this actually as an alternative fuel, presumably to alleviate global climatic disruption, global warming. However, your point is very, very well taken. This is not the way to go, because when one does this, one is destroying tremendous biodiversity and replacing it with one single species and cutting and destroying the greatest ecosystem in terms of biodiversity in the world. In fact, it's actually making global warming worse, because the amount of fuel produced and used by the palm oil is much less than the amount of increased global warming gases caused by, number one, cutting the trees that carry out photosynthesis to take carbon dioxide, the main greenhouse gas, out of the atmosphere, but also because when you cut the trees or burn them, you're adding carbon dioxide to the air. So you're actually making the problem worse. So the real incentive there is for these multinational corporations to make money.
You are listening to
Jungle Deep.
Hello, this is Dr. Jones. I believe that the destruction of the tropical rainforest is humankind's greatest environmental problem. Not climate change, not pollution, not nuclear waste, not food production, not a whole host of topics you could add to the list. I care about these things, and I have to admit that climate change and the depletion of the oceans have my particular attention. But I know that the destruction of the tropical rainforest is number one. Now, I would not be surprised if you told me that none of the people around you in your daily life are doing anything to help save the remaining tropical rainforest. We obviously have to change this situation. Many people do not take action on this issue because they're confused about what to do. Confusion breeds inaction. Well, I have a solution. Visit the Jungle Deep website and look in the directory at the top of the show homepage for my new article called How Can I Help Save the Rainforest? It includes my 5 steps to saving the rainforest. It's simple, direct, clear-cut. Oh, I probably shouldn't have used that expression. It's direct and it's simple. Anyone can follow these steps, and everyone should. Get a copy into the hands of everyone around you. At the very least, it's a great conversation starter. And together, when there's enough of us taking action, we will save both humanity and the planet. Read and print out the list, 5 Steps to Saving the Rainforest, from the Jungle Deep website. Go to calaverasgold.tv and click on Jungle Deep in the directory.
This is Kelly Camille Patterson of the Velveteen Lounge Kitchen, and I make my lime jello marshmallow cottage cheese surprise while listening to Jungle Deep.
Hi, I'm Al Bowl, film producer of Tarzan, Lord of the Louisiana Jungle, and I clean my lenses while listening to Jungle Deep.
Aloha, this is Marty Lush from the Tiki Aki Orchestra. And when I'm not vibing with the band, I'm listening to the vibes of Ken Jones and Jungle Deep.
Hi, this is your host, Ken Jones, from the Prince of Ponds podcast. The frogs are shaking the shakers, the turtles are hitting the slapsticks, and the koi are blowing the trumpets. It's party time at the Prince of Ponds. Out under the swaying palm trees, the pond fairies are kicking up their heels, spinning into light in the twilight. It's time to celebrate the magic of ponds, waterfalls, fountains, and water gardens at the Prince of Ponds podcast.
Hello, this is Dr. Jones. I believe the better you get to know the jungle's wonderful creatures, the more you will care about them. And as you care about them, you'll want to join with me in efforts to protect them and save them from extinction. I want to draw your attention to the Jungle Deep website and the ways I am promoting tropical rainforest education and conservation. In addition to the awesome expert guests and regular reports from our wonderful field correspondents on the podcast, I am building a website with resources to help everyone, especially students, find helpful and motivating information. One example is the new Wildlife Theater, which will contain a collection of photos and videos of exotic animals from the jungles around the world. Top-notch zoos and other conservation groups are contributing content to the Jungle Deep Wildlife Theater. You will find the Jungle Deep website by going to www.calaverasgold.tv. That's Calaveras, C-A-L-A-V-E-R-A-S, gold, G-O-L-D, like the mineral, .tv, as in television, and clicking on Jungle Deep in the directory. Check the Jungle Deep website often because it's growing every week. Jungle Deep is a one-of-a-kind podcast that promotes conservation in a most entertaining way. If you want me to make more Jungle Deep episodes, let me know by making a donation to this environmental education podcast. If you would like, for a donation of $20 or more, I'll be happy to make a shout-out on the show. That's a short message about your favorite wildlife or conservation organization. You may send any amount by check mailed to me, the producer, Ken Jones, at P.O. Box 61, Murphy's, M-U-R-P-H-Y-S, California, 95247. You know, most people don't make a donation and just listen to the podcast for free. That makes your donation all the more important. The core message of Jungle Deep is that we need more people to participate in conservation. It's not enough to love nature. These days, caring about the environment absolutely requires action. Your action in support of this show will be used to grow Jungle Deep and to help me reach more people with our conservation message. Thank you. Now, more of
Jungle Deep. Deep.
So, yes, this is very serious. As I say, it's destroying the habitats of animals and causing the extinction of animal and plant species in the rainforest. And it really needs to be stopped, and we need to find other ways to alleviate global warming, such as getting people out of cars and planes and into trains, energy efficiency in our refrigerators, conservation, and solar and wind.
And so it'd be correct to say there's no way that replacing a complex tropical rainforest with a simple monoculture plantation of one crop or another, there's no way that replacing crop can do nearly what a normal or natural tropical rainforest does as far as consuming CO2 and supporting the water cycle that's necessary to maintain the weather patterns that the rainforest do.
Right. No way it can support the water cycle. And even when you count the fuel that's produced, because palm oil can be used as an alternative fuel, it doesn't make up for the increased global warming problems that you're adding, the increased greenhouse gases from cutting the rainforest. Also, remember, you're affecting the very complex ecosystem of the soil. And plus, you are just simply decreasing biodiversity by destroying the most highly biodiverse ecosystem in the world and replacing it with a monoculture. So there's the complex interactions and the efficiency of recycling of nutrients and use of nutrients and the water cycle as well as the carbon cycle, which evolved over millions of years, hundreds of millions of years, cannot be replaced by a monoculture that competes with what nature can do in any way. You're absolutely right about that.
Well, gosh, this is such a big subject, and there's so many different directions we could go with our conversation. I just know I'm going to have to ask you to come back so that we can explore some of these other things. There's so many things we have not even touched on yet, like logging and exactly what biodiversity hotspots are and what can be done to protect them, and so forth and so on. So I sure hope you'll come back and explore some of these other topics with us in the near future. I'd like to ask you one question as we wrap up here for today, though. If I had a blank check here and I could write any sum of money for any purpose that would help you with your work, What would that be for? What would you like to do if you could be empowered with some funding? What's on your plate?
I'd like to do just what we're doing, empower the indigenous people. But I'd also like to go with a fellow that I'm working with who, he actually lives in Costa Rica, but he was raised in Ecuador, and he has very, very good connections with the indigenous people, the local people who are not, you know, native peoples, and with the Ecuadorian government. And he has a commitment from the Ecuadorian government to expand a national park if he can remove the people who are in that area and give them a sustainable living and get the lawyers paid to do the legal work of setting up the national park. And this area, which is currently being logged in Ecuador and is rainforest, is an area where the Andes and the rainforest come together and is therefore actually the highest biodiversity ecosystem on the planet today. So we are working to help him, and he estimates that if we raise $250,000, we can win this one and save it.
Wow.
Very exciting to be able to save the most highly biodiverse area in the world. So I'd like to do that. If I had unlimited funds, I would save all of the, what you just mentioned, the biodiversity hotspots in the world. That means the area's highest of biodiversity in the world, which are largely rainforests, but not exclusively. Some of them are mangrove and wetlands, and some of them are coral reef, which are very, very diverse. There are somewhere around 25 of these hotspots, which quite amazingly could be saved, not maintained, but just bought up and saved for $20 billion, estimated by the great evolutionary biologist E.O. Wilson at Harvard. Now, you would need...
Now, that's a pretty big check.
Yeah, well, you'd need billions more to maintain them. But actually, $20 billion... It's a big check for a group like ours, but in the scheme of things, it's nothing. I mean, one of these military airplanes that the U.S. has, you know, these monster airplanes in the military cost less than that. You know, some of the CEO salaries that for their bonuses are comparable to $20 billion, you know, if not one CEO, but just a few. And, you know, the bailout for the banks, I think, by comparison, is quite a bit less than $20 billion.
Certainly helps to put a number on it to help give all of us a feeling for the scope of it and the fact that it can be done, because it needs to be done. We need to save our most diverse areas on the planet, to save as many species as possible. That to save them all, it makes perfect sense, is what we should be doing. So... it helps to get a feeling for just how big this job is and what it is that we should be aiming for.
Yeah, and my point is that $20 billion is actually a very low number when you put it in perspective.
Compared to a lot of other things.
Yeah. The U.S., you know, the total U.S. budget, the bailout of the banks.
It should be done. It should be doable.
Yeah. I mean, it's nothing compared to our military budget. You could take $20 billion from our military budget, and they wouldn't even notice it. It's a drop in the bucket.
But I'm afraid our environmental efforts, all the conservations together, is still not getting the public support or the kind of attention it needs to get to succeed. And that's frankly why this podcast is here. So,
it's because although it's a difficult battle, we can't throw in the towel, and we've got to win this one. The future of the planet and frankly the survival of the human race depends on it.
Yes. So, well, great work that you're doing. Thank you for all your input on the show today. Before we go, give your website address one more time and how people should get in touch with you when they're ready to learn more about the World Rainforest Fund.
Okay, the website is worldrainforest.org. You can read about us there and our work, and you can go to the donation link and donate to us that way. And you can also send us a check made out to World Rainforest Fund if you want to donate that to us. On the envelope, you'd write World Rainforest Fund, 1888 Pomar Way, Walnut Creek, California, 94598-1424, and Pomaraway is spelled P-O-M-A-R, new word, W-A-Y. That's 1888 Pomaraway, Walnut Creek, California, 94598-1424, and if you'd like to write me at that address, you may do so. If you'd like to call me and talk about this, I'm David Seaborg, and my business line is 925-938-9206.
Very good, David. Thank you so very much for being with us today, and I look forward to talking with you again real soon.
Thank you for having me, Ken. It's been a real pleasure educating people about the need to save our biodiversity and rainforest.
Well, I sure hope to have you back again soon. Thank you and goodbye.
Bye.
Be sure to share Jungle Deep Podcast with your friends and coworkers. The show is my creation and at my personal expense. It is not currently subsidized by any business or organization. Audience growth is especially important for Jungle Deep to succeed and prosper. So share the show. You can see beautiful photos and learn more about Jungle Deep at our website, calaverasgold.tv. Now that's Spanish, Calaveras, C-A-L-A-V-E-R-A-S, gold, G-O-L-D, like the mineral, .tv, like television. You gotta check it out. Where else can you go for this kind of fun? Just click on the Jungle Deep title in the header directory. Our show notes pages have valuable links for you. I invite you to email me at jungledeep@calaverasgold.tv and follow me on Twitter. Search for Jungle Deep or KenJones56, all one word. I would love to hear your ideas for the show. Well, the show's over for today, so it's time to refill my Mai Tai, mount my elephant, and head back into the jungle.